Hi Farmies, Mrs. North here. I am going to talk to you today about cephalosporins, and our prototype drug is cefalexin, otherwise known as Keflex. So cephalosporins is a classification that is grouped into generations. It's kind of a family tree of drugs. Keflex is a first generation drug, and what happens, the reason they have more generations is because as they work on developing these drugs, they create drugs that are more and more able to attack gram-negative bacteria. So the higher the generation, the more it will attack gram-negative bacteria, and actually it loses a little for gram-positive, but it just becomes a broader spectrum. So a fourth generation cephalosporin is going to be a broader spectrum antibiotic than a first generation. So cephalosporins, you can see the word ceph, C-E-F in cephalosporins. In the generic name, you can almost always see a C-E-F of some sort. Sometimes you see it in the brand name. For example, ceftriaxone is rocephin. So the ceph is in both of those. Cephalozoin and Ancef, the ceph is in both of those. But cefepime, the brand name for cefepime is maxepime, so it's not 100% in the brand names of the drugs. So let's talk about cephalosporin. It works like penicillin. It will attack the cell wall, kind of stick its foot in the door, weaken the cell walls so that the fluids outside the cell can come into the cell and the cell will rupture. So it is a bactericidal antibiotic. But it does not work, it's very broad spectrum, but it doesn't work against all antibiotics. Against all organisms. And for that reason, it can contribute to antibiotic resistance. So when we give a broad spectrum antibiotic while we wait for a patient's microbiology to come back, the bugs that it doesn't kill can become resistant, and these resistant organisms can overgrow and cause a super infection. So one of the things that we really worry about with cephalosporins is these super infections. So super means above. So this is an infection above the one they already have. Two very common super infections are Candida albicans and C. difficile. So Candida albicans causes yeast infections in thrush, and we give nystatin for that. Clostridium difficile, that's the GI upset that you get, an overgrowth of bad bacteria in your gut. So those are the two things we worry about, those two kinds of super infections that we can worry about. And like I said, this has a cross-sensitivity to penicillin. They work the same way, so if somebody is allergic to the cephalosporins, that would indicate they are also allergic to penicillins, and we shouldn't give it. Sometimes the reverse isn't always true. If you're allergic to penicillin, you might not be allergic to cephalosporin, and we might try that. But if you are allergic to cephalosporin, you're almost for sure allergic to penicillin. All right, so I think that's all the really important stuff I have to tell you about cephalosporin. Our drug is Keflex. So remember, Keflex, potential for super infections, and cross-sensitivity to penicillin. Have a great day.